we're going to be talking about kissing numbers, which is perhaps less exciting than it sounds. It sounds like we're taking the name of the channel a bit too far. Kissing numbers is actually about how many spheres we can fit around a central sphere. It comes from billiards. So when two billiards make contact, they kiss. And this actually was the source of a bit of a disagreement between two mathematicians, a guy called Isaac Newton, I don't know if you've heard of him, and a guy called David Gregory. And they disagreed how many spheres you could fit around a central sphere. So David Gregory went to Isaac Newton, because he's the guy, right? They were talking about planets and how they move around, and then they went off topic, and Newton said, you can fit 12 spheres around a central sphere. David Gregory thought, no, actually, I think possibly you might be able to fit 13, fit one more in. If you look at the traditional hexagonal packing, this would be 12 spheres around the central sphere. So you've got the central sphere here, you've got six going around the equator, you'd have three at the top and three below it, which means you have 12 spheres fitting around the central sphere. And if you extend that forever, that's the hexagonal packing, and that's rigid as well. It doesn't seem possible that you can fit in any extra spheres into that structure. Well, actually, that's not the only way of fitting spheres around the central sphere. Another possibility would be something more like the spots on a football. I said I was going to hope it, I had it there, and it wasn't. So imagine we put the spheres exactly where the spots are on this football. So there'd be one at the top, there'd be one at the bottom, and then we'd have a row of five around the top and another row of five around here at the bottom. So I've got a prop here. So it's made out of bouncing balls and cocktail sticks, kind of like the football. I was trying to fit spheres around the central sphere, but can you see? If I do that, there are massive gaps. I don't know if I can turn it over, find any other massive gaps. Look, I can see another massive gap here. Perhaps if we bunch up these spheres, these gaps will be big enough to fit in an extra one. So that was the problem. So let's see who was correct.
My money's on Newton.
You're gonna think Newton?
Yeah.
All right, let's have a look. So it's not obvious what is the correct answer. Let me show you why you might think it's 13. Imagine I contained this prop I've made in another sphere. So if these had radius one, then the big sphere that's going to contain it would have a radius of three. In fact, I'll draw it out. Five, six, something like that. Right, these are spheres. So imagine they are spheres. Now we're going to contain this in a larger sphere. Now imagine we put a light right in the middle of this sphere. So we're going to shine a light and we're going to cast a shadow on the inside of the surface of the big sphere, like this. So if you do the calculations, and if you look at the area that these shadows cast, there is enough space on the inside of this massive sphere to fit 14 shadows, nearly 15 actually, not quite enough for 15, but definitely 14. So it seems like you should be able to fit 13 perhaps. That argument would work if we're talking about circles. Fitting circles within one big circle, and you looked at the shadows, then you would get six shadows, and you can fit six circles around a central circle. So it seems like this argument suggests that you can fit 13 spheres, maybe even 14, but it was difficult to prove. So if we want to do it with two dimensions, it's actually not that difficult to show that the kissing number is six. And you might be able to see then, if they were any closer, they would overlap. So it's not too hard to show that six is the maximum number of circles you can fit round here. Another way of saying that is if you look at the kissing points here, like this, they make an angle of 60 degrees. And that's true on a sphere as well. The kissing points will make an angle of at least 60 degrees. So let me just draw out a sphere to show you the sort of thing I mean by that. And let's have a point on the surface. Let's call that point X. We'll give it a coordinate. So in three-dimensional space, it would have coordinates. We'll call it X1, X2, X3. And let's have another kissing point on the surface. We'll call that Y. A couple of things I can tell you about these points that are on this sphere. If this is a sphere of radius 1, then I can tell you with a bit of Pythagoras that if I use the coordinates, x1 squared plus x2 squared plus x3 squared is equal to the radius squared. The radius is 1, so I can say that's equal to 1. So that's going to be true. The other thing I wanted to point out is the angle between these kissing points is going to be at least 60 degrees. Now, there's a formula for working out the angle using the coordinates based on the cosine of an angle. So let's say the angle is theta. That's a traditional symbol to use. So we're going to look at the cosine of that angle, theta. The formula for that, using coordinates, is x1 multiplied by y1 plus x2 multiplied by y2 plus x3 multiplied by y3. Now, I want this angle to be greater than 60 degrees. That means that this cosine is less than a half. And we've got these two little formulas here. Surely, using these formulas, this is enough information to work out how many kissing points we have on the sphere. So you can do that. I've seen a more modern proof of this by a mathematician called Oleg Musin. And he showed that you can have a little function, something that's based on all the angles between the kissing points. I'm just going to call it S for no reason. He showed that this thing is always greater than or equal to the kissing number squared and less than 13 times the kissing number, which is enough to prove the kissing number has to be less than 13. The kissing number must be less than 13. So you can prove that is true, but we already know an example where the kissing number is 12. So that's it. So the kissing number is 12. That must be the maximum number that you can fit around a central sphere. So guess who was right? After all, of course, Isaac Newton was right.
Had Isaac Newton done any proofs, or did he just have a gut feeling?
That was a gut feeling of Isaac Newton, yes. So you shouldn't disagree with Isaac Newton's gut feelings. So I mentioned that I've read a more modern proof of this by Oleg Musin. He actually showed what the kissing number would be for the next dimension up, for four-dimensional spheres. Now, this is getting into crazy areas, right? I can't imagine what a four-dimensional sphere looks like. I have no idea what that means. When you start getting into higher dimensions, I start to rely purely on the formulas. So a formula, then, for a four-dimensional sphere. Well, remember, these are points on the surface of the sphere, and we're just going to extend these formulas we already found for three dimensions. In four dimensions, a point that is on the surface would have a first coordinate squared plus the second coordinate squared plus the third coordinate squared plus the fourth coordinate squared would equal to the radius squared, which, let's say it's radius 1, so it'd be 1. So I would just rely on what those formulas mean, because I just can't picture what a four-dimensional sphere would look like. So, but he had the same argument. So using these kind of formulas, went through the same kind of argument and worked out the kissing number for four-dimensional spheres had to be less than 25, strictly less than 25, and he already knew there was an example of 24. So there is a structure that has a kissing number of 24. It's called the 24 cell. It's in a four-dimensional space, but we already know one that has 24, so that's it. So the kissing number in dimension 4 is 24. For higher dimensions, 5, 6, 7, we don't know. We don't know what the kissing numbers are. But bizarrely, we do know the answer in dimensions 8 and dimensions 24. So in dimension 8, so imagine 8 dimensional spheres, the kissing number is 240. So you would have 240 spheres around a central sphere. And in dimension 24, the kissing number is 196,500. Imagine all those spheres around a central sphere. And we know the kissing numbers in those particular dimensions because we have structures that are particularly regular, which makes it easier to prove what the kissing number is. Now, those are regular structures. There is no reason to believe that in higher dimensions that the maximum kissing number is going to be with a regular structure. It's probably going to be an irregular structure. In fact, I can give you an example of that, because in dimension 9, we've shown that all the regular structures have a kissing number that is less than 272. But we have an example of an irregular structure which has a kissing number of 306. So it's higher than all the regular structures. So why are 8 and 24 special in this? When we have these regular structures in dimensions 8 and in dimension 24, the gaps start to get bigger, and then they get so big that you can fit in extra spheres into the gaps. And that's true at dimension 8, it's true at dimension 24. So just because of that property, we can really pack in those spheres in those particular dimensions.
This is the second in a Sphere trilogy of videos with Dr. Grime. There are more details in the video description, and it was brought to you by Brilliant. You know, I think we're all pretty familiar with how we can make our bodies more fit. We can exercise, we can go to the gym, we can run. But how do you make your brain more fit? How do you improve your thinking? Well, a great way to do it is going along to Brilliant, where they've got all sorts of puzzles and quizzes and courses that are specially designed to change the way you think, to make you smarter. This isn't memorizing equations. These aren't things that are going to help you pass that next test. This is about changing the way you're wired, changing the way you attack problems. Everything's beautifully designed. It's really clever. There's lots of free content on the site, but you can also get 20% off a premium subscription, which unlocks all the goodies, by going to brilliant.org/numberphile. The URL's on the screen and in the description. Our thanks to Brilliant for supporting this video.